North Korea is home to nearly 216 million tons of rare earth oxides, double that of the world's known reserves. Below the nation's mostly mountainous surface are vast mineral reserves including iron, gold, zinc, copper, and more. There are about 200 kinds of minerals present which factories in nearby countries require to make smartphones and other high-tech products. According to an estimate from a South Korean state-owned mining company, North Korea's reserves are worth over $6 trillion, while another South Korean research institute puts the amount closer to $10 trillion. They are sitting on a pile of big fat fortune which will change the country's weightage in the global markets by kicking countries like India, China and Brazil out of the game. Well, why haven't they done it already? North Korea's mining production has decreased significantly since the early 90s. It is likely that the average operational rate of its existing mining facilities is much below 30% of its capacity. And along with that, there is a shortage of mining equipment, and the country is unable to purchase new equipment due to its dire economic situation. However, North Korea has been particularly active in coal mining in the recent years. In 2015, China imported about $1 billion worth of coal from North Korea. Coal is especially appealing because it can be mined with relatively simple equipment. Large deposits of the mineral are located near major ports and the border with China and Russia, making the nation's bad transportation infrastructure less of an issue. For years now, Chinese buyers have purchased coal from North Korea at a price far below the market rate. As of last summer, coal shipments to China accounted for 40% of all of North Korea's exports. But the global demand for coal is declining as alternatives like natural gas and renewable sources are gaining momentum. And that's not it. After North Korea conducted its first nuclear test in 2006, the UN began imposing even stronger sanctions against it. In November 2016, the UN passed a resolution capping North Korea's coal exports and banning shipments of nickel, copper, zinc, and even silver. And this was followed by another resolution that banned the export of gold, titanium, and other rare earth metals. North Korea's neighbors have long had their eyes on its bonanza of mineral wealth. About 5 years ago, China spent some $10 billion on an infrastructure project near the border with North Korea to give easier access to the mineral resources. Though Russia and China are developing strategies to utilize the country's treasure box, South Korea, on the other hand, has its own plan for the mineral resources. It probably sees it as a way to help pay for the reunification, which is expected to take decades and cost billions or even trillions of dollars.